The sad music.
Yeah, let me plug in my controller.
Oh, that's funny.
I have to restart the game. God, we're gonna have to have that fucking music again. Hold on. Oh no, I don't think I have to restart. We're good. So this is fair. So this is Fahrenheit. This is a game that I started playing yesterday. It is from 2006, I think. I'm actually, like, I'm shaky at the moment. It'll go away. This is from, like, 2006. But they remastered it, like, 6 years ago. And my head's not in the game, so let's just give it a minute. And then we'll get back to it, and I'll give you a summary of what happened in yesterday's session. It's good stuff. It's good stuff. Just like our memories someday will. What, be remastered? Insta story. Yeah, I gotta do an Insta story. Nah, I was just talking memories. Gotta. Sorry, I've been really emotional recently. It's okay. It's okay to cry, guys. Always remember that. There's nothing wrong with crying every now and then. Okay, I gotta have a better story, though. I can't, like, come on all serious looking. Just give me a second. Ever since that shit in the garden. No, Pata, your corn. Oh, buddy. It was, I'm just gonna get it off my chest so that I can move on. Just give me a sec. It was Max's funeral. It was Max's birthday yesterday. So I'm a little emotional today because I forgot until today. Sorry, I had to get that out. And I was doing okay until I started talking about us playing COD. Just in a minute. Who's Max? He's, a childhood friend of mine. He passed away in December. Sorry. I'm really sorry. I need a mute, don't I? This combo really isn't great. Let me just mute for a second and let's get some better music going.
Oh.
So sorry. God, it's that sad violin. Okay. Okay.
Sorry to hear that. Oh.
Did I just imagine someone coming into the stream? I'm sat here crying and there's violin music playing.
Oh. Okay. Whew.
Yeah.
It's funny how close crying and laughing are in emotions. You wouldn't think they would be. But they really are. I often laugh and cry kind of in the same moment. I don't know what that is. I'm really curious about that. Oh.
I include all of that and more to you. Someone sits down and like, oh, nice. I've been waiting for part two of this playthrough. They sit down with some popcorn. I there start talking about my friend who passed away and I cry. They're really like, uh-huh, man.
Okay.
Pata as well. He came to sit down. He sits down with his burnt corn. I come with a really sad subject.
Oh, okay. How's everyone doing? You know what, I'm gonna put on some water, make a cup of tea, I think, just to kind of reset.
Nizay, thanks for the 5 gifted subs. And secretly a taco. Thanks for the 2 subs. Cheers, guys. It's very nice. Nosy dog fight with the 300 bits as well. And $3 coming in hot from Killerna. Here, my yearbook quote. Everyone else is stuff like memories from school. And then there's me. With toes are just thicker fingers, but I quoted you. I did not steal it. Lots of love, Theo. Love your vids and love just you in general.
Dude, killer that. In 20 years' time, I really hope you look at that and laugh. And don't go like, man, I could have had anything. And it's this stupid fucking quote.
What do people put? That's not a thing here. What does one usually put as their yearbook quote? I'm curious.
Yoink!
Thank you very much. I'm honored, Killer. I'm honored. I just put a smiley face. What happened? Oh yeah! Did you go and redo your corn, Pata? I cried. Yeah, I was actually laughing about the fact that I joked that it'll be really sad if you just sat down to have a good stream and stuff, and then I just start crying. You're like trying to distract yourself, you know? So you had good timing, actually. You missed it. Unless, of course, you want to see me cry. If so, you'll have to go back in the VOD. I'm all cried out now. What would be your yearbook quote? God, knowing me back then, probably like boobs or something. I love boobies. Like XD. I'd probably do XD. Something terrible. That's why I don't think I'm into yearbook quotes, because I feel like most people then are kind of cringe when you're that age. You'll look back at it and be like, oh man, why'd I write that? Isn't it weird you just sat down and cried in front of thousands of people? Nah, I'm used to it. Internet's a weird place. It's cool. Yeah, it's fascinating. But I'm used to it at this point. I'm always crying on here. I mean, you guys have seen my sweaty ass. I feel like we're past that point. It's okay. Oh, I should probably clarify. Like, you haven't seen... I mean, not like my full-on bare skin ass. But, you know, just the, you know, yeah, you know the clip. Whether you, if you know it, you know it. That was a great night, he says. That image is forever stuck in my mind. Mine too. I could see it right now. Good. It's good. Anyway, I'm gonna go make my tea. I'll be right back.
Okay.
Okay. God. I was this close. This close when I was this close when I sat down and said okay. So just that I was really close to just start crying again. That's why I laughed. because I did. I've just gotten myself together. I arrive with my tea, you know. And I just get back to it. I'm good. Yeah, a little bit of a roller coaster. It's making me laugh. Right, so let's play Fahrenheit. This is, for those who weren't here yesterday, this isn't up on Mortio yet, the first session, so I'll summarize what's happened here. Funnily enough, we have played 4 hours of this, and I would say it's pretty easy to summarize what's happened. Boom, boom. The guy we're playing as is named Lucas. Oh, same guy as 7-year-old Lucas who was in the resub earlier. He killed someone accidentally. He was in a trance and he killed someone in a bathroom. And he's like, I swear it wasn't me. I don't know what happened. He killed him with a knife. Like, he blacked out, basically. He was at the cafe, suddenly he, like, comes to, and he's in the middle of stabbing this dude. So you play as him, and you play as two different cops. And they are trying to figure out who he is, who murdered this guy. They're trying to figure out the murder. That's basically it. I mean, Lucas... okay, so there's a couple more things. Lucas... has told his brother Marcus about this, who's a priest. Is Cadus here? Cadus wanted me to summarize. Cadus, are you here? God, is Cadus, has he gone for a piss or something? Is he gonna come back and be like, can you summarize? Cadus! Oh my god, okay. Well, you snooze, you lose. So his priest brother knows. And, what more? The cop has found out. The cop got an email. The cop got an email saying this has happened before. And then gave a note as a little, like... And then just wrote a name. The name was Kirsten. So she looks up. The cop looks up Kirsten in the database. And finds a classified file. And she can't access it. I believe now that she's gone down to the library and actually found the physical file, and she hasn't actually read it yet, as far as I'm aware, if I can remember right. Also, the mortuary guy, when he was going through the body, was like, I've seen this exact thing before, because a knife wound was, like, really perfectly cut around the heart, and he said Kirsten was the victim's name, and it's a case from the 90s, so we haven't found out about that yet, but we're about to. And lastly, Lucas, our killer, he can see into the future. Yeah. It's a very small note, but it's a very big note. He can see into the future. He keeps having visions of something that's about to happen in a few seconds. And because of that, he ended up saving, I chose to save a little kid who slipped into the ice and started drowning. And, but for doing so, the cop who was a witness of me killing that dude that fateful night, that cop happened to spot me there, and he chose to not arrest me and didn't say anything and let me go because I saved the kid. And that's everything. The epic gym scene needs a mention. Okay. The two cops fought in the gym. They're having a bit of a spar. Also, for some reason, the library I went to, the guy owning it put on the most stereotypical, like, God, I'm gonna get canceled even, like, trying to say it. So, it was really weird. And then he lost the accent, halfway through. So, That was an odd one. But yeah, that's it. Okay, he starts dancing. I don't think it's set to my controller. Hold on. Controls. He's so perfectly centered. Okay, great. We're gonna have to restart the game. Hold on a sec, please. Oh yeah, my ex Tiffany came and picked up her stuff as well. Lucas's stuff, the killer. And I tried to kiss her. She turned me down. Any questions? Agent Newhouse, thanks for the 3 months. And Blind Berserker with the 7 months. Much love. Congrats on the job. Congrats on moving in together. And congrats on the Corsair Virtuoso wireless headset. Oh, right, Insta story. God, I mean, this stream is a fucking mess. Hi, everyone. I am live. We are continuing my playthrough of Fahrenheit. I'll see you in chat. Chat, I'm just gonna straight up ask. You don't have to tell me what happens, but can anyone tell me, yes or no, if I run out of lives because I miss QuickTime events, you know, when I miss a QuickTime event and I lose a life, if I lose them all, do I have to start the game from the beginning? Yes or no? No, no, maybe. Yes, permadeath is in this game. Maybe, yeah, I believe so. No, no, no. No, you restart the chapter. I thought you restart the chapter. I figured you restart the chapter. Because I would honestly turn on difficulty to hard if I knew it wasn't perma. But whatever. Go on. Has it saved, or do I have to talk to this guy again? Because that was a great conversation. I'm not really sure. Let's find out by... We'll find out, and it all depends on what accent he has.
Yo!
We have to do it again. Okay.
Excuse me? I am sorry to cause a wedding on you. Your presence here bring honor to my miserable shop. My name is Takyo. Tell me what I can do to make you happy.
Damn. This guy looks just like that old Chinese dude in Gremlins.
Don't say, don't chat.
If he offers me a little box with a monster in it, I am gone.
Don't chat. Okay.
I was digging around in my closet and I found this old book. Thought it might be worth something.
Ah, unhappily, I am but a worthless well of ignorance. My tiny expertise extend wholly to books I serve here.
Well, actually, I'm a detective.
No! Oh, why'd I go with that again?
Immigration? You come like my pleasure? All paper store family is legal. You verify it. No problem.
Okay, okay, calm down. I'm not here to bust you.
If you no got warrant, you go now. This private property.
Yeah, great strategy, Tyler. Nice work. Thanks anyway. At least I tried.
Oh.
There we go. Okay. There is something I can do for you. One client.
I know where the book is, so this is going to be quick.
Their book. Since this morning, I look for it, but impossible to find. You find this book, and I tell you all you want to know.
So, what does it
look like,
this book you want?
Ah, easy. It from
the reason I'm here, chat, in case you're wondering, is
this one.
There was an old book left behind Lucas the Killer at the cafe.
Bring back the sacred diamond of the old sage of the mountain, and he will give you the magic.
That's why I'm here asking this guy for expertise.
Oh, man.
Trying to find out any details I can about the book that the killer left behind. Oh my god, I can't even go collect it yet because my character hasn't looked at the magnifying glass. Okay. Right, yeah. This is how I got details about the book that he left behind. There. You gonna talk about it, or?
There's something handwritten in pencil here. To my brother for his 18th birthday, MK. Interesting.
Well, yesterday this guy didn't end up telling me anything after I found him his book. But I thought maybe I selected the wrong conversation choices.
Looks like a
complete gonna give it another go.
A bunch of numbers fell out of the book. Must have been a bookmark. I'll check it out at the office.
Cuz I ended up getting to ask him about two things. And one of the things I asked him about was why he's lost the accent, which was such a waste. So I'm not gonna ask him about this time. I'm gonna ask him about something else. Watch this.
Okay, here's your book.
Oh, great. You found it. Thanks, dude. What do you want to know about that book?
Who sold?
Is there any way to find out who would have sold this book?
Fuck, did I ask that yesterday? I might have asked that yesterday.
Nah, this book ain't worth enough for any seller to remember it.
It does sound like Groot, actually. You're right. Book.
Can you tell me anything about the book?
Yes, nice edition. Leather cover, looks like one in the Shakespeare series published by Lamarck and Everett, 1884.
Yo, thanks for your help.
What?
No problem. Come by again, okay?
Okay. And now we haven't played anything. We just had to redo that scene.
Guess it didn't save properly.
Why did he get a Brooklyn accent? I asked him about it yesterday, and he said he does it to fuck with people, basically. I think it was something like that. Make them more comfortable. It was something like that. We're gonna go to Lucas Kane at Agatha's house. Why are we at... Who's that? Agatha, yeah. But who is that?
Here it is.
Here it is, apparently. You know what? I gotta make my video public. One second. Didn't realize how late it was.
Videos.
Ba-dum-bum-bum.
Lollipop, lollipop, ooh, lolly, 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 lollipop, lollipop, ooh, lolly, 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 lollipop.
Ba-dum-bum-bum.
Lollipop,
yoink! Okay, there we go. Today's video is a Elden Ring video. It's 38 minutes long. And then tomorrow is the last Elden Ring video, which features Millennia. You're killing a few views, streaming and publishing at the same time. People are gonna stay to watch live thing. You know what, Assassin? I don't really care. I can't. If I'm gonna get to that point, then what am I doing, you know? Am I gonna be here like, guys, I'm gonna go offline for an hour so that you go watch the video, and then I'll be back. Like, I can't really, can't do that. It's too try hard. Do we know who Agatha is? Your brother said she might have answers. Perfect, thank you. Right, yeah, the priest thing. He was like, oh, I may know someone who can help you.
Is there anyone here?
Streamers wait for the video premiere to finish and then go on Twitch. Yeah, I did it with a video a while back. Was it last week? 2 weeks ago. I premiered a video. The Pogostock, the final Pogostock video, I premiered it. And then I advertised in it, in the chat, saying, I'm gonna go live with a horror game. And that did really well. But, I mean, that's... I can't do that every time, because my videos go live so late.
Old plates on the shelf.
Yeah, it did kind of sound like Flash, actually.
Are those crows in the cages? Are those crows in the cages? Eesh, pretty gloomy pets.
There has been a crow theme with us as we've been playing. There was a crow who watched me murder that man.
An old wickerwork chest of drawers.
There was also an old wickerwood chest of drawers there that night as well. Coincidence? Who knows?
Is anyone at home?
Candlesticks, an old grimoire. Weird atmosphere.
Yeah, it had feet. It ran with me as I left. Didn't want to get blamed for the murder.
A stuffed crow. The clock has stopped.
Why is he just... Oh.
Are you Agatha?
Why do you want to talk to Agatha?
Marcus.
Father Marcus Kane sent me here. I have a problem. I need to talk to her about it.
She transforms into a crow.
A problem? And who on earth doesn't have problems?
Well, to be fair, he's got a pretty big problem.
One need not have eyes to see. Be kind, young man. Push me over to my birds. It'll be more comfortable for us to talk over there.
Who does that? I snoop around.
The cupboard is locked.
Bonus! That's why you always snoop around in strangers' bathrooms. You never know what kind of collectible you're gonna find, guys. There's something over here. I swear there was a different icon when I was there. Hold on, madam, I'm just checking the area. You don't want to be here and do like a seance?
The bird is such a unique animal. It can spend its entire life locked up in a cage and yet still keep on singing away. What brings you here, young man? Tell me, what is your cage like?
David Cage!
I killed a man. It was like I was possessed. I watched it all happen, but I had no control over my actions.
Sounds like a rather commonplace story to me.
Thanks.
Don't you think that it might simply be because you've gone mad?
Vision. I had a vision of another man, making exactly the same movements as me, and of a little girl who called out to me for help.
In the cupboard, you will find a little bag of seeds. Be a good boy. Feed some to my little darlings, will you?
I think she's bad. I don't think she's good. I think we got something to deal with here. She made me do it. Can you imagine the smell in here? Well, that one doesn't get any of it. Oh, okay. Trigger.
Do you have any memory of what could have triggered your loss of control? Did you drink something, hear a sound, or see an image which seemed out of the ordinary?
I have no idea. In fact, I can't remember anything that happened to me from the time I entered the place to when I woke up again afterwards.
Have you experienced any other strange manifestations since then? Have you had any odd dreams or visions?
Visions of the future.
Yes. I see things as if the reality in front of me was deforming, becoming horrible.
Are you
you also see the future.
Concrete to your vision, such as a symbol or sign, maybe a word.
When I regained control of myself after the murder, this symbol had been cut into my wrist with a knife.
A snake. Two open jaws. Oh, dear God.
What does it mean?
A snake.
There's only one way for me to be sure. Please, push me into the sitting room.
He has bandages on. How much did that hurt? Take her outside. Oh, no. He's joined our internet issues fixed. No. They're gonna get back to me. I've called them. If I have any issues tonight, it's around now that it's gonna happen.
You'll find some candles in one of the cupboards. Take them and place them in the candle holders. There should be some matches in the kitchen. Go find them and light the candles.
Fuck, what did she say? Matches in the kitchen. Where were the candles? I just bring her with me for the rest of the game. One candle. Oh, they need me to find three candles. Is that it? Do they want me to find three candles? Oh, God. Are they all in here? Do I take them one by one? Oh, it was the second one. Stop that. Another candle? No. All right, where's the kitchen? Okay. One will be enough, I'm sure. Yoink!
Nothing in particular.
does sound a lot like Flash.
Take the knife.
Nothing in particular.
No!
Perfect. We're almost ready to begin. Turn off the light. Close the curtains.
True,
and sit
Rob.
Down next
I remember
to
the
me.
Baby. What?
The only way to understand what has happened to you is to try to go deep into your unconscious memory. Whoever it was that forced you to commit this murder has erased himself from your memory. But there still must be a trace in your unconscious. I can help you to locate it. It's an exhausting ceremony, and there's always a risk involved. Do you, or do you not wish to try it?
Yes, I do.
Give me your hands. Now, close your eyes. I want you to empty your mind and open wide against your unconscious. And let me enter there. That. We're still together. Lucas, are you there?
Yes.
I want you to return to the restaurant just before the events began. Evacuate all extraneous thoughts and wander freely through your memory. Where are you?
Standing outside the restaurant.
I want you to enter the restaurant now.
I've gone into the restaurant.
What do you see?
I see some customers. And I see the waitress.
It's gonna be that hooded guy by the end, shorty.
Can you see the table where you were sitting?
I'm looking. There's a police officer. He's sitting at the counter.
Concentrate, Lucas. Now, walk to your table.
Standing next to my table, but it's empty.
You haven't arrived and sat down there yet?
Yes, I have. My meal is already on the table. I think this is when I murdered him.
Stay calm, Lucas. I want you to tell me exactly where you are.
I'm in the restroom, and so is the other man.
What's he doing?
He's urinating. He doesn't suspect anything.
And you, Lucas? Where are you?
I'm cutting myself in
the bathroom.
I don't
know. I can't see myself. There I am. I was in a toilet stall. Oh my God. I'm holding a knife. He doesn't see me.
Calm yourself, Lucas. keep your concentration.
I can't control my steps. I'm walking up behind the man. He doesn't see me. I don't want to. I don't want to, but I can't stop myself.
I want you to re-enter the restaurant. But now, it is prior to going into the toilet stall. Do you understand, Lucas? Before. Where are you now?
I'm in the restaurant dining room again.
Are you sitting at your table?
Yes, I am. I can see myself.
What are you doing, Lucas?
I'm eating. I'm eating and reading a book.
A book?
Yes. Shakespeare. The Tempest.
A very thin book.
What else do you see?
As I told thee before, I am subject to a tyrant, a sorcerer, that by his cunning hath cheated me of the island.
What did you say?
It's a passage from Shakespeare's Tempest. That's what you're reading, is it not?
Yes. Someone's coming toward me. A man.
Who is it? A customer?
I don't know. I think so. I can't see his face.
And what does he say to you?
I don't know. I can't remember.
You must concentrate, Lucas. You need to remember.
It's one of my favorite books. A shame so few people read Shakespeare these days. Would you mind if I sat down for a moment?
Ah, it's just that... The man sat down at my table and now the waitress is coming.
Sir?
A coffee, please.
Why wouldn't
waitress,
she mention this?
It's as if she didn't
everything?
See the man, like he was invisible.
So much has been written about the Tempest, especially concerning the theme of magic.
And now, what's happening, Lucas?
I don't know. The man gives off a very strange energy. It's hard to describe.
Go on, Lucas. What happens after that?
Do you believe in the power of magic?
No, I don't.
Like Morpheus.
Listen,
You're wrong. You know there's much more to our universe than can be perceived by the naked eye.
Your coffee, sir.
Thanks, Kate.
So she can see
it. The waitress has brought him his coffee, but she's talking to me as if I was the one who ordered it. She doesn't know that he's there. She can't see him.
And now, what's happening?
Listen, I don't want to be rude, but I'd rather eat alone.
Master Noctilan, Katlan Nekli, Kortniklan, Arniklan, Neknesta, Arniklan,
I'm paralyzed. I can't feel my body. I can't move.
The man, Lucas. Where is the man?
He stood up. He's gone out. He's in my head now. He controls me.
Follow the man, Lucas. Hurry. I command you to follow that man closely.
The homeless dude! It's the homeless man! What?
Your mind and his are now linked. You can see what he sees.
You know who that man was, don't you?
No. I don't know. I'm not sure who he is.
Yes, you do know who he is. You understood it all as soon as you felt the scars on my arms. What do these symbols mean, Agatha? Tell me what that man's done to me!
You should go now, Lucas. There's nothing more that I can do for you.
You could at least explain what the hell's happening to me! He made me kill a man! I want to know! I need to know!
I have to verify certain things. There's nothing more I can tell you today. Come back tomorrow night at the same time. I'll explain.
He's gonna be
more
dead.
Then.
You know, it's funny to me. You know when, at the starting scene, after he's killed the guy, what's the point of them zooming in on the homeless man after that scene? What's the reasoning behind that? They do this really obvious, like, zoom in to his face, and he stood there smiling with, like, a scar on his eye. Just a dude. Witness. I don't know, man. Like, the way they showed him, like, they were really just like, this guy is gonna be really important. It's funny to me. I feel like it wasn't even necessary. Because you'd still know about him if you go out there as the cop and you meet him then he can have the scar, but he doesn't have to be so suspicious, like smiling at the camera, like, you know. I don't know what kind of like writing decision that is to have that in the first scene. Let's go with Carla. He said he saw the devil come out, but then he was very dismissive about it. It's probably not
him.
True, actually.
Thanks.
He did say that, so maybe he saw the devil come out. I don't know, though. He had that scar on his eye.
Sergeant Mitchell?
Yes?
So guys, I'm the cop now, Carla, one of the cops, and I have found out that there's a very similar case to the current murder case that happened in the 90s. And I found the case files, and in it, this office detective, sergeant I'm about to talk to, was the detective on the case from the 90s.
Inspector Carla Valenti, would you mind if I asked you a few questions concerning one of my investigations?
Young lady, I haven't worked in investigations for a long time. I doubt I can be much help.
It's concerning an old case, but I'm still looking into it. The Kirsten case?
Because you can't locate the file, is that right?
Yes, that's right. The file's been classified.
How'd you like to do some target practice with me?
Sure. Why not?
Your gun is right in front of you. Go ahead.
Wait, a mansplain? Come on, man. So, a fucking detective. She knows what she's doing. Let me show you. Let me show you I know how to do this. Press the R button to shoot. Press the RS button to reload. The R button? Fuck. Kill terrorists to gain time. What? Okay, don't shoot innocents to avoid time penalties. Chat! Now this game is from the mid-2000s. 2006, 2005, around that time. So, let's just see how... Listen, don't... Okay, let's just play this. So, R to shoot, R... I think R is R1. I think I've gotten that before. R is... Okay. Okay. Okay, we're good. I was getting a little nervous there. Oh my god, this is fucking... Does it matter where I hit them? I don't think it does.
That doesn't matter. Oh fuck, there's one in the back. This is where I wish I was playing with the... Dude, this is the one where the mouse... Playing with the mouse would have been good. You think the better I do this, the more he's gonna tell me? Because he's like, impressed that I'm a real cop. Fuck! Got his gun? What the fuck?
You're a very good shot. I have to say, you're a heck of a lot better than most I see around here.
Damn, I needed a mouse for
so,
that. I think I could go way longer.
Case?
Well, for instance, what exactly happened?
Guy named Kirsten's calmly shopping in his local supermarket. He's in the kitchen accessories aisle. When someone picks up a knife, stabs him to death.
What do you know about the victim?
Nothing unusual in his past. He was just in the wrong place at the wrong time.
Any other interesting elements in the case?
Ah, one more detail. The killer then used the knife to carve some symbols on his own forearms. Very weird stuff. It looked like a snake or a serpent.
Maybe he just cracked, lost it for a moment. Some people are like time bombs just waiting to go off.
That's the first theory I had, until I saw the coroner's report. Each knife entry cut cleanly into an artery, leading to the heart with perfect accuracy. Precision like that, I mean, the guy had a one in a million chance of doing that, even if he'd been a surgeon.
What? Silently. Okay, no, you know what? I'll figure out how to reload. On the reload button. This is great. I already like this. Gets faster and faster. What did I get last time with the controller? Does anyone remember? This is my new favorite game. Just this. Whoa! Ooh. Shit! I'm insane. What happened in the game? This is it. We're forever stuck in a loop of aim training. Can you imagine having a conversation and then she quietly turns around and just silently does this for the next 3 minutes? She's still in the game.
Excellent target. Looks like you're...
Alright, back to controller.
Natural.
Thank you. Alright, back to the investigation.
You didn't stop your investigation there, did you?
No, this case really intrigued me. What could have motivated him to do something like that? I mean, I checked out piles of leads and discovered almost by accident that this wasn't the first. There had been other killings with the same profile.
You mean where the killer had the same bizarre MO and stuck around afterwards?
Exactly. 3 weeks earlier, on the other side of town, another stabbing victim in the middle of the street, no motive. Then I discovered a third case, 2 months prior to that. Then another, and another, and always the same MO.
Links.
You mean to say the killings are all connected?
No idea. All I know is that the murders were basically identical. He slices the arteries leading to the heart, slices them cleanly, and then carves a symbol on his own arms.
And your investigation into the supermarket killing. Did it lead anywhere?
You should drop this one, Detective.
Wait.
This is not just a murder case.
How does he know about the symbols on the arms of all the killers?
Behind the scenes.
Looks like I'll be starting a new file.
If he didn't arrest anyone. Oh, I should have asked about arrests. No, I'm good. Okay, thank God.
I'd worked good and hard on the investigation. Done everything Carla had asked.
Oh yeah, okay. No, I owe this guy $100. This is really integral to the story of the game, chat. Very important you know what's going on here. We're about to play some basketball. This guy came up to me and he said, "Hey, where's my $100, man?" And so I said that double or nothing. We'll play some basketball. If he wins, I give him $200 on the spot. If I win, we're even. I don't owe him any money. And this is integral to the story. Very important you know what's going on here.
Relax and play.
It's gonna be intense.
And also settle a little score I had with Jeffrey. Yo, nice threads, Jeffrey. Very stylish, my man. You got me totally psyched out in that shit.
Right. Okay, here's the rules. First to score 10 points wins the game and $200. That cool for you?
You can kiss your money goodbye.
We'll see. Let's do it.
Okay.
Speed, technique, killer ball handling. Watch and learn, bro.
Boom! This reminds me of... Reminds me of that scene in Catwoman. It's around the same time, actually. Didn't Catwoman come out around this time? What is it with awkwardly long, out-of-nowhere basketball scenes in movies and games around, like, the mid-early 2000s? Oh, was it Daredevil? I swear there's something similar in Catwoman as well. The Catwoman with, Halle Berry. I feel like they both have an awkward scene. The one in Daredevil is with Elektra, right? What are they doing? They both have an awkward scene, but I swear I can remember the Catwoman one because I remember the cop she's doing it with.
Yes. Now that
Do they
was
play
pure
basketball
poetry
in both
motion.
Of them? Yeah, they fight in Daredevil. That's what they do. Yeah. In, like, the parking lot or something. It's fucking weird. Yeah. Nice try, Jeffrey. Does the game mechanic work? It's my sticks. Left stick, right stick. And it's directions. Why does Jeffrey look like a 12-year-old and a 40-year-old at the same time? Yeah. I'm getting the smack talk ready. Goes really serious mid basketball.
Haha, you look 12 and 40 at the same time.
Oh shit, oh shit, 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 shit. I still make it. Nailed it. Ah, Jeffrey, Jeffrey, Jeffrey. Say goodbye to those $100.
He hits the lane, he drives, then he scores. Ladies and gentlemen, that's our play of the day.
That's gonna make me feel good.
You D up pretty good for a white cop.
You ain't so bad yourself. You got some game.
nice.
Maybe I should have mentioned. I did some ball at college. So, as for the 100, it's game over, man.
You're a real SOB, Tyler.
I know, and that's why you like me, Jeffrey.
Carla's place first this time. Scully! Good to see you. 45 months. How's your day going? It's good, thank you. That's like actually insane. Oh, 45 months, yeah. I've had a credit card. I'm completely butchering your Visa messenger, Scully. Kappa. Either way. I just skimmed through a joke. Much love, Scully. Hope you have a lovely day. Much love. Much love. I hope your pets are good as well. Franco, let's move on. Thanks for the 37. Lamborghini. I'm Pasta Gaming. Dinner for our anniversary. I won't be able to make it. I'm hanging out with chat. Thanks for the 1 year, Pasta. And DLT with the 19 months. Yoink! I've been away for a while, but I always have you on in the background on Morteo. Thanks for being you. I hope life keeps bringing you all the amazing things you want and deserve. Oh, thanks. Vincent Buschetta. Thanks for the 14 months. Is it true that if you go to your friend's house in Sweden, you have to wait while they eat? Yeah, as a kid, sometimes I wasn't served food. I saw that tweet. Most of the time, though, it's if I come when he's... No, but you know why, though? The memories I have of going to my friend's place and them... There was a tweet that went big about, like, how in Sweden you don't... get served food, especially as a kid. I got served plenty of food as a kid, but I think a lot of the memories I have where they didn't serve me food, it's when I came around lunchtime and I had already eaten lunch. And then I get there and I'm with my friend for like 10 minutes and then it's lunchtime for him. So I just wait while he goes and eats lunch for 10 minutes. You know, I think most of my my memories of not having... eating with the family or whatever when I'm at a friend's place is that kind of memory where it's like I've already eaten, you know.
Yoink.
Not sitting at the table even. No, my memory is that I'd just wait in his room. He goes and eats. But I also have plenty of memories where I ate at my friend's place. It's not like it's a customary? It's not like it's like a Swedish custom to not eat at your friend's place. I think that'll have been overstated on like social media if so. And they're like, yeah, totally. Us Swedes are so weird. I have so many memories eating at a friend's place. Like, but I, yeah, it's a little of both. Me it's awkward with my friend's family. Yeah, I think that was it. Like, I think, yeah, I just have a lot of memories of coming when it's lunchtime and, like, they're about to eat, you know? It's just like, I'll just wait in your room while you go eat. Cremate! Thanks for the 37. Thanks, I knew internet was overblowing it. Yeah, it happens every now and then. I saw one which people asked me about, which was, like, a condom taxi saying, like, oh, in Sweden... they have, like, condom deliveries if you need a condom. And people were like, Theo, is this true? It was that stupid fucking Twitter account that used to just... what was it called? Uber Facts or whatever? Whatever happened to that? I think I blocked it. Maybe it's still around. They'd always just tweet fully false things. And, like... and that was one of them. I mean, that one, for all I know, it could be true that there is... one guy who has that as a service where he delivers a condom if you need it by stopping with a van, you know. But it's not like a... it became like a, wow, have you heard that in Sweden they deliver condoms? And it's not a thing. like, you know, instant service kind of thing. That's, you know, happens every now and then.
Thank you.
Oh, I can walk. Sorry. Where the fuck is my phone? Ah.
Sure took your time.
I was in the shower. What do you got?
I got nothing. Dead end. Impossible to ID the page marker found in the book from the restaurant. It's got a series of numeric codes written on it, but it just looks like a lot of numbers to me. I thought you might have some ideas.
Why don't you fax it to me? I wasn't tired anyway. I'm sure it'll make for good bedtime reading.
Okay, I'll send it now. If you get any brainstorms, give me a ring. I'll be here for a while. Tonight's gonna be a long one.
Okay, talk to you later, Tyler.
This David Cage guy seems to be quite into to the ladies, the lady scenes. Yeah, Heavy Rain had one as well. I swear they have one in Detroit Become Human, but I can't quite remember. It was a while ago. Now, but this like showering scene. Intrigued.
I had a gut feeling that I was holding the key that would identify our killer. I felt like I was closing in on him, and I wasn't about to go home to sleep until I figured out what this paper meant.
I'd want him beyond Two Souls as well. Mm. Until Dawn with Sam. Yeah. I'm seeing a pattern here. Right, I've got to fax this to her. Is that David Cage? What, this? Yeah. Or what? No. He's done all of those games. Well, not him. You know, him and his studio, I guess. Oh, shit. Maybe I have to... Am I done? Oh? And now what? No, Until Dawn isn't David Cage. No, you're right. It's not. But, Heavy Rain, Beyond Two Souls, Detroit Become Human. Okay, do I have a fax machine somewhere? Yes.
The bookmark we found in the killer's book. Letters and figures. I wonder what it means.
Can't you explain what a fax machine is? It's magic. Pure magic. Facts, how old is this game? Like 2006, Pata? Everybody knows we were all faxing back then. Not an old fax machine in our apartment. My printer can fax. It's more the time it's being played in. Is this being played earlier? Is it being played in the 90s? Just a bird with featherweight curves. From Tommy. Hi, Carla. I'm sorry I wasn't able to give you any news for a while. I've been very busy with my job. I'll drop by your place as soon as I can to tell you about my latest adventures. Lots of kisses. Tommy. Who the fuck is this Tommy guy? Why wasn't I told about him? Omicron, the first part of the trilogy, beats all records. Last weekend... Last weekend, the first part of the Omicron trilogy. It's an article from today. God, the Corona trilogy. Last weekend, the first part of the Omicron trilogy broke all box office records. The grand-scale science fiction... I don't care about this. David Cage, I do care. Succeeded in rousing the enthusiasm of both the general public and the critics, so much so that it is already being listed as a major favorite for the Oscars. I'm particularly pleased at the response to my film, said David Cage, the French director. Adapting a video game for film is a major challenge. Jackson Peters, in person, declared that he was particularly impressed by the visual originality of the film. Some critics claim that the subject of the film, which relates the story of a civilization that is manipulated by those in control and numbed to sleep by the media, is not unconnected to its immense popular success. Alright, we got a bunch of deaths because it's getting even colder.
I've got to call Tyler.
Oh, okay, sorry. Omicron is a game David Cage played before this. Oh, really? Now, hold on.
Who could that be at this hour? Not expecting anyone.
Let me call Tyler first.
Tyler Miles.
It's a list of stock quotes. Our bookmark was printed in a bank.
Stock quotes? How'd you figure that out?
It'd take too long to explain. There's got to be a way to identify the bank that printed out that list.
Yeah, you're right. Damn, there's got to be a way. First one who finds it calls the other back.
Okay, well, it's going to have to be you, Tyler, because I got someone at the door. I am not wearing any clothes.
You can't open the door dressed like
this. You're right. Why is the... Okay. Yeah, hold on, buddy. Let me just... Yeah, hold on! I'm fully dressed. You have to see
just I was feeling kind of bored, and thought as my official friendly neighbor you'd agree to share my boredom. And this excellent bottle of French Chablis.
In my capacity as your friendly neighbor, I wouldn't think of refusing your boring invitation or your excellent wine, Tommy.
I imagine that even a die-hard bachelorette like yourself must have some wine glasses around here somewhere.
Yoink!
I think I do have some. Somewhere. Sit down, Tommy.
I'll find like him. I don't like him either, to be honest. There's something about him. He seems too innocent. Do I have the wine glasses in my fridge? No? Just a bunch of milk? Are they in here? Ah, here we go. Hold on, everybody. My wife has texted me, and she needs me to answer her. Oh yeah, because this is important. Ah, maybe it is. Sorry, Alex. There you go. Oh, the eye contact. Okay.
A toast?
All right. What to?
To love. What else?
I'll drink to that. Are you with anyone?
Well, actually, I did meet someone 2 weeks ago.
It's her.
He's
They're role playing.
He's very real and very nice.
Oh, he's gay.
And he works in a bank, too. I think this time it could turn into something serious. Are you still single? What's a beautiful girl like you waiting for? Go find yourself a nice guy.
Oh yeah, no, he's gay.
If there's one thing New York has lots of, it's handsome men.
I don't know. I guess the desire is just not there. My last romantic experiences were total disasters. I'm not ready for anything or anyone just yet.
Did he say that he works at a bank?
I'm happy to see you got your smile back.
We all have our ups and downs, right? I always thought that people in New York didn't give a damn about gayness. They were so enlightened. How wrong.
The guy he's seeing is Lucas.
They still look at us as being different from so-called normal folks. Enough small talk. Look at what I brought.
Tarot cards?
I'm going to read your future.
You mean you know how to use those things?
This guy's not the killer.
My grandmother was a psychic. She taught me how to read the cards when I was just a kid.
I was a little suspicious of this guy. I thought maybe he was the magic dude. Although now he is.
You know? What the cards foretell always come to pass. Let's see if you're going to meet your true soulmate or if you're going to die as a wrinkled old maid.
Now he is bringing out magic stuff.
Okay, Mr. Gypsy. Tell me what I'm supposed to do.
It's easy. First, take the cards and mix them up.
Is there a new murder? No. Not yet. Ah, dude, I do not like his energy, though. Okay.
Take two cards.
Left thumbstick to move.
Yoink!
What's this tiny rectangle vision? Alright, we'll take this one. Oh, Le Monde. With boobies. More boobies, eh? And?
There's going to be a dark period.
La Lille.
An escape. And terrible danger. Take two more cards. You're not alone. You're following someone, and he is disturbing. He hides a heavy secret. Take two more cards, please. There is a curse, great suffering and fear. I see dark death and distress. Yes, just come to me whenever you need cheering up. Seriously, I'm sorry, Carla. This is not turning out to be as much fun as I thought.
It's okay, Tommy. Let's see what horrors my destiny holds for me. Here are two more cards.
She knows how to play?
One child. Two destinies. A path toward life, the other path toward death. Carla, I think we'll stop there. I'm sorry, I don't know what happened. It's the first time I've ever read this sort of thing in the cards. Usually don't express anything like this.
Don't apologize, Tommy. It's just a silly game. I never believed in fortune-telling anyway.
Well, I've got to get home. It's late.
What? What?
Hey, since when are you interested in investments?
It's about one of my investigations. I thought maybe you could help me with a question I have. I was wondering, is there a way to identify a bank from a list of stock quotes that they've printed?
From your facts, no. But normally the original document is printed on watermarked paper showing a numeric ID code identifying the bank.
He knows this because his boyfriend comes up with the most boring subjects. All right,
I'll check our document to see.
Or does he work at the bank as well, maybe?
Good night, Carla.
He must work at the bank as well. Perhaps he does.
That's it. I've got to call Tyler.
Tyler! Tyler! Tyler!
Yeah?
Our bookmark should be watermarked with the bank's ID code.
I'll check it out and call you right back.
Turn on the light. And now. Move the light with the joystick with the direction keys.
I think I found it.
Tyler?
I've got the code. You should have no trouble identifying which bank it corresponds to.
This time we've got our killer. I think I'll pay a little visit to the bank tomorrow.
You want me to go?
No, I'd rather go myself if you don't mind. I'd like to see what our boy looks like. We'll meet afterwards at the station and compare notes. See you tomorrow, Tyler.
Okay, see you then, Carla.
We're going as Carla. Yes, hello, Lucas speaking.
Lucas Kane.
Master Noctilan, Katanekli, Courtney
Clan,
Nitan.
No!
Apanin, Oni, Iglan, Tainon.
Okay. Come on, Lucas. You don't want to kill again. Nice.
Good dodging in that beer bottle. Nice, good work.
Woo, close one. The boxes, the boxes! Oh, nice.
Oh.
You're doing good work here, man. Just stand completely still, don't use your feet. Oh. What's happening? Oh shit! Great work. Oh, watch out for that! Oh, sorry. Fuck, I lost a life. Oh no, oh no! Ooh, close. Nice dodge. Ooh, jump. Good work. Oh, behind you, behind you! The couch! Not the couch! No! Okay. Nice. What's next? The phone. Oh god, not the phone! I don't remember this. I don't remember the- Oh, back to this. Watch out for the boxes. Okay, ready? Another one of these. Literally left for 2 seconds. What's happening? We're fighting the wind.
No!
No! Okay.
Ah!
Why is he... Why is he...
Ah, there's more furniture!
We gotta run for the balcony. Give it all you got, Lucas. There's surely nothing else they can throw at us.
No! No!
Lucas's terrifying story haunted me all night long. I had to see him, to talk to him. I had to find out what Agatha had told him. I wanted to look my brother in the eye and hear the truth. I'd never been to his apartment before, and it took me some time to find him.
This is my brother? My priest brother. Oh, shit! Lucas! I've had a premonition!
Lucas Kane, that's it.
Lucas! I can feel the voice of God within me. He tells me you're in danger. Oh. Lucas!
Lucas, open the door! Lucas!
Slam it open, priest.
I heard a scream coming from inside. The doorman said Lucas was at home, but he isn't opening. Lucas is in danger. I've got no other choice.
Nice! First try. Yeah? There, a hand. Whose hand could it be?
Lucas! Oh my God!
Brother!
Oh, this is very important. We got it.
And that's how my story ends. Officially, they called it a suicide. I'd never find out the truth about what really happened to me in that restaurant on that cold January night. I'd never know who it was that killed me.
Barely gave me any time. Chat. If I... Surely, if I run out of lives, that's what happens. You know, if I run out of lives during the quick time events, surely I just go back to the save, right? Or is it perma? I'm so curious. Does anyone know? It's not perma. Test it? Well, if I'm wrong, then the game ends. I play this game a lot, not perma. Okay, in that case, I'm turning up the difficulty to hard.
Lucas Kane, that's it. Lucas? Lucas, open the door! Lucas! I could swear that I heard a scream coming from inside.
I love that we have to rewatch
this. Lucas was at home, but he isn't opening.
Okay, here we go. Testing hard difficulty.
I've got no other choice.
Nice, okay, easy. Here we go. Critical
Lucas!
Moment. Critical moment.
Oh my God.
Okay, we're good. We're good. We're good. Thank God, Lucas. You could have fallen.
Lucas,
hold on. Did I trust a guy who said
sake.
I play this game
have
a lot?
You lost your mind? What's come over you?
This
the
of
walls,
all games?
The walls were blown away and the wind, the tempest, I... Why did you do this, Lucas? Why? Somebody tried to kill me. For heaven's sake, Lucas. There's no one else here but you and I. You were all alone when I arrived. All alone, Lucas.
What's happening to me, Marcus? I don't know what's happening!
It'll be all right, Lucas. Everything will be fine. I'm gonna help you. You'll see. I finally convinced Marcus to let me go out. I'd slept most of the day, and he'd stayed to watch over me. I needed to get out and get back in touch with reality. My physical condition was deteriorating rapidly. My mental state wasn't much better.
Chat, who am I?
I felt myself slipping away. I knew that it wouldn't be long before I lost it.
Hello, I'm Detective Carla Valenti, NYPD.
Piano cat! Oh, shit!
The police, they found me.
I'm Ray William Johnson. Okay, we gotta go. We gotta go. It's a scene from The Matrix. Hide under the desk, maybe? No? Do we just go out the door? That's not
a
good idea, okay.
It's too late for me to think about running.
It's too late for me to think about running. Well, then what the fuck are my options? Go through the vent? Can I do that? Alright, well, I'll sit back down then and... Oh!
A torn piece of computer paper. I think I must have used it for a bookmark.
Pick it up!
Uh-oh, I'd better try to hide this.
You're gonna... Just eat it. Just eat it! Eat it! Where are we? Oh, in the book. Hide it in the book. Hide it in the book. Oh my god! Okay, hide it in the book.
Richard III. I often read Shakespeare. I like
Fuck!
The sober, desperate tone.
Yeah, I don't care about the monologue! Pick it up! And now we gotta hide them, bro!
Marcus gave me this book, along with the one I left in the restaurant.
Great!
Better not leave it lying around.
Hide it! Okay. Fuck!
Hello, I'm Detective Carla Valenti, NYPD. You are Lucas Kane, right? I'd like to ask you a couple of questions.
Not a problem. What is
questions?
This about?
What about?
I'm working on a homicide case, and we have reason to believe that the murderer worked at this bank.
What do you want to know?
Could
not
you confirm
surprised.
That this
okay,
list came from here at the bank?
Truth.
The paper does come from here. It has our bank ID code and the watermark.
Is there a way to establish where it was printed from? The manager already filled me in, but maybe we can learn something more.
This kind of paper is used by stock buyers to print out their quotes. There's about 100 of them here in the bank.
Why no get ready? Did I miss a get ready? What are you doing, bro? No, don't freak out. Stop it. Okay, stay calm.
Is there a problem, Mr. Kane?
Stay calm.
Huh? No.
Oh, I looked away during the get ready.
Is
okay, get ready.
Is there a way to determine where this particular document was printed out? What's his problem? Seems like my
No, everything's fine. Everything's fine. No.
No, not really. Our printers don't leave any identifiable marks.
What a shame.
A witness helped us make a composite photo of the suspect. Would you mind taking a look at it for us?
Not a problem at all. Are you seeing this? Are you seeing this, woman? Stay calm. Stay calm. Let's get up. Touch my face a little bit like a normal person does. Certainly. Certainly.
Are you all right, sir?
Yes.
Got a bad leg.
I'm fine.
You got a bad leg.
Tense. I've got to keep cool.
Keep it cool, buddy.
This remind you of anyone?
Say a joke. Yeah, a joke. That it's you.
Hey, this looks like a lot of people I know. It could even be me.
Nice. Chill.
Right, these composites can be a little vague.
Yeah. the average white guy. Okay, here we go. Yeah, 1, 2, 3, 3, 4, 5. Nice.
Damn.
Right.
It would have made my life a lot easier if he'd recognized somebody.
Yeah. What a shame. Oh, God. Okay. It's not an issue. There's nothing in the room but you and me.
Are you sure you're all right?
I'm perfectly fine.
I thought that...
Now, don't show your arms. Don't show your arms. Oh, shit. She's going to see the band-aids. She's going to see the bandages.
Have you noticed anything unusual here at the bank lately? They told me about what happened to this guy yesterday. I wonder if he's going to mention it.
I am going to mention it. I have an illness.
Yes. Actually, I'm susceptible to epileptic seizures.
Nice.
They're fairly rare, but they can be violent. In fact, I had one yesterday, and I'm afraid I put on quite a show. But that's about the only unusual thing that's happened here recently.
Okay.
That's strange. His forearms are bandaged.
Okay, think of a lie, think
of
a lie.
What happened to him? Did something happen to your arms?
Epileptic seizure? Fell into a window.
Oh, I had a stupid accident doing some...
Okay.
Home repair work. I guess I'm not much of a Mr. Fix-It guy.
Yeah.
Is that you in the picture with the priest? Is he a friend of yours? That priest looks a lot like him. Maybe a member of his family.
Yeah, that's fine. Tell him the truth. What's
wrong
with that?
That's my brother, Marcus.
Okay. Okay. We're just thrown into it. Not a problem. Oh shit, I'm wrecked. This isn't good. Oh no.
Are you sure you're feeling all right? You seem a little peakish.
Ask her out.
I might have
ask her out.
Cold.
Dodge the question, ask her out. Keep your enemies close, Lucas. Okay.
He's lying to me. I can smell it. Damn, maybe this is our guy right here.
No!
Stranger things have happened.
No. If I were the killer, would I ask you out
I'm
for a date?
I'm not feeling very well. I'm just gonna go and splash some water on my face.
Oh, buddy.
Go right
why
ahead.
Did you say
I'll
that?
Wait for you here.
No! No! Oh, luckily I didn't hide the stuff. I kept it on
He's acting so strangely. I'd better take a quick look inside his desk before he gets back.
I'm now her. What's this? Could this be the killer?
Shakespeare
just like the one in the restaurant.
That's worth checking out. I'll just remove it discreetly.
You won't be missing that one. What's this photo? Okay, we don't care about the photo. A pen.
There ought to be some fingerprints on it.
Let's take it.
See if this is our man.
Let's just straight up steal from this guy. What else have we got in here? Oh, I checked there already. What more could we possibly find? Damn, so I missed one book, I guess. Oh shit, he's coming back. I better not get caught on his computer.
Nothing much of interest here.
Yes, hello, Lucas. I was doing nothing. I've been standing here since you left.
Feeling better?
Yes. Thanks.
I don't have any more questions. I'll let you get back to work. Thank you for your cooperation, sir.
That was the book you hid? Really? He hid it in his desk? That's an odd one. Alright, I need a 1 minute break.
Oh, you know,
if I was caught doing a crime by a cop, like if a cop comes around the corner in an alleyway, catches me mid-act murdering someone,
And like, if he comes any closer and turns the corner, he's gonna see the body. And I have to lie to him real quick about what I'm doing, and he can tell that I'm flustered. I give him something really awkward that explains why I'm flustered, in order for him to leave, rather than come closer and try to investigate further. So, I'm caught in the alleyway, the dead body's around the corner right next to me, behind a dumpster. He's in front of me. If he walks forward any longer, any closer, he's gonna see it. I tell him, to tell you the truth, my sister is currently living with me in my one-room apartment because she divorced her husband, and I can't find any alone time, so I came here to wank. Boom. The cop understands why I'm flustered, and he walks away. Next level thinking. Now you've just outed that strat, though. Say anything. Anything embarrassing. I really, really had to take a shit. Please don't find me for doing it out in public, but I've got food poisoning and I was on my way home. Easy. Then he arrests you for public indecency? No, I don't think he'd bother. I'd rather take that coin flip than him moving forward and spotting the body. I haven't done it yet. I may as well just say, I came here to take a shit, but you're right, I shouldn't. I'll go home and poo instead. But man, is there any cafe around the corner or something? I'm about to burst, man. Boom. He's like, yeah, come with me, man. I got a toilet right over here. They'll find the body sometime and remember the guy wanking exactly there. And now it's even worse. He believes that I was wanking, but to the body. That's in the headlines, and I'm like, no! No, I just killed him! The wanking wasn't true, guys. If it's just you and the cop, surely you just kill the cop? What kind of pro are you, man? Like, in my world, I'm me stood there. I've just accidentally killed the man because he was trying to mug me and we got in a fight. And in the moment, I lie to the cop because I think I'm going to get arrested for it. But if the cop shows up, I'm not going to be like, I have to take you out next. Like, I'm not gonna be able to do that. Why don't you say that you just found the body? I don't think they'd believe that, to be honest. Thank God you're here. This guy, he died by it's clearly a knife wound. It was this knife, sir. Let me give it to you. You could pull off a good Riddler, Teo. A good Riddler? What does he say? 17 plus 3. That's the answer to this one, Batman. Riddle me this. That's the one. Riddle me this. That's a tough riddle.
Yoink!
Oh. You know what I really like? I really like the college humor Batman funny videos. They're very funny.
I don't know what they're called. They're called something like Fat Man or something. They're not called Fat Man. Bad Man. Are they called Bad Man? They're really funny. Justice. Care to show us? I don't think I can. I can show you a clip just so you get the idea of what it's about. They're really, really funny. Where's the one with the Riddler?
Rachel!
Rachel! Batman!
Rachel!
Batman!
Not so fast. Riddle me this, Batman.
Riddler, no.
If you aim to give us a shot, we'll riddle you. What are we?
Oh, that is a stumper. Say it again.
If you aim to give us a shot, we'll riddle you.
Batman, it's bull-
wait. No hints. Is it?
You think the answer to my riddle is buh?
I heard Rachel say.
Don't worry about what she says. Worry.
Is it? Helicopter.
All right. Now what did I say that would make you think helicopter?
It's what you said. If your aim is to, I have no idea. Man, I'm just shooting in the dark.
Listen, if you aim
with a gun
to give us a shot, we'll riddle you
with little pieces of metal that are called.
What are they called? What's gonna come out of the gun?
Injustice. The tools of cowards and criminals.
Are you serious right now? Because I've got about 10 more of these riddles. They're way harder than this one. This is like just
another really funny one. I think, what was my favorite one? It was, this one. This one's funny, man.
All right, Wiggles the Clown, drunk and disorderly at a children's party. Nice. What do you have to say for yourself?
Evening, Commissioner.
What the hell? Isn't that kind of bad?
Hi. Do you want to know how I got these scars?
But then that means Batman is...
Oh, God! Come on!
Oh, my head! Oh, everything's fuzzy.
Ah!
Who punches a hand?
You wanted me. Here I am.
I didn't want you. I don't even know who you are.
Where's Dent?
I don't know who Dent is. I think you broke my balloon tying hand.
You're garbage who kills for money.
No, I'm Wiggles. Garbage is a different clown that works the East End of... God, no!
Where's Dent?
I don't know. I was hired by Leo Bonner for his son's birthday. I do close-up magic.
I have one rule.
I am so sorry I broke your rule, Giant Bat. All I drank was 2 beers and some cooking sherry.
Which is?
Some fortified wine. Ah!
Oh! Oh, great Scott, come on.
Ah! Where are they?
Oh!
Ah! Where are they?
I got drunk at a birthday party! I'm sorry!
Batman, stop! It's not the Joker, it's a birthday clown. You stop punching him in the face.
Really?
That's not the Joker.
That's the Joker.
No, that's not.
Looks like the Joker.
No, look at him, he is not the Joker.
2 clowns?
Right.
Full disclosure, part of me knew that. Yeah, it was embarrassing to stop, but what do you say? So I just kind of owned it. I gave you the beating, not that you deserved, but the one that he needed.
Right, he didn't do anything.
Harvey did.
Right.
Can we trust him? No,
we're past that.
There's nowhere to go in here. Sorry, champ. You want one of my telescopes?
I am so sorry about that, Wiggles. A little bit of a mix-up down here.
My father was a drinker and a fool.
Come on!
Reality! God damn it!
Good shit, dude. There's so many of those, though. If you want to look at them yourselves, look up just College Humor Batman. Or just College Humor Batman. There's a whole series of them. They're really funny. I'm gonna go pee, and then we'll keep playing a little bit. I'll be right back. Looked at the Elden Ring video. It's doing well. Top comment, as it always is on these Elden Ring videos, is that they hate seeing me with this terrible weapon or something. Every video, somebody mentions it, and it's top comment. I don't read these. People are just like, they'll just get annoyed that I'm playing it the wrong way. You mean the weapon that made Millennia kneel? Yeah, that's the one. You know what I've noticed, actually? Speaking of disliking comments, Bubble. I don't think they work. Has anyone ever seen evidence of disliking a comment working? Like, if I see a comment with two thumbs up, and I give it a thumbs down and refresh, I've never seen that actually take it down to one. Only the channel creators will. No, you're thinking of the video, Shark Hunt. I'm talking about thumbing down a comment. Obviously, there's no dislikes on comments, but I've never seen, like, the like counter go down from a dislike on a comment. They've been disabled? No, oh yeah, no, not videos, Shark Hunt. The comments. The thumb down button has never worked. It's very odd that they have that in the first place. Maybe it's for the algorithm? Maybe it's like if a lot of people thumb it down, then it disappears from the top comments section? Maybe that's what it's about? I've seen comments going lower in the comment section. I've tried many times. Like, I've always been like, does this work? Click and like refresh a few times and it just doesn't change the counter. Yeah, it's probably to do with YouTube's system more than anything. Like, for the algorithm to know if it's doing right or wrong regarding putting certain comments high up on the top section. Anyway, tires me out, man. I was kind of excited to do an Elden Ring series, but it's really put me off from reading the comments, because every time it's the same thing. Like, I get it. I get if you feel that way, but do you have to do it as, like, just don't watch me play it. Ugh. Anyway, Zaramid, thanks for subscribing. OneDZ, thanks for the tier 3 resub. Much love. Logapo, with the 16 months, I beat Elden Ring, so I celebrate with some prime content. Congratulations, must be a very nice feeling. Cameron MCC, with the 7 months, have you ever farted in a bucket? Can't say I have. Have you? And Anne Ladhar, thanks for the resub. You get many spam comments? No. Do you? That was I was still thinking of the fart comment. No. What do you mean by spam comment? There are many elitists in Dark Souls community. Yeah. Oh yeah, I've noticed. Oh, there's usually spam comments like the first 50, you know, when the video goes up, there's a lot of just like, not spam, but a lot of like generic comments. Because they obviously haven't watched the video yet. And they'll just be like, hey, love you. I wouldn't count that as spam. I wonder how many people actually read comments on YouTube videos. I tend to read through them the first couple of days after they're uploaded. And then I stop because you get way more critical comments that aren't even like... It's just gonna put me down if I read them after a few days. But as I said, I avoid looking at Elden Ring comments for the most part because it's just, I don't know. There's still going to be a lot of lovely comments, but it's not very nice. Like, it's not like they're hating on me. They're not, they could be way worse, you know, but I just get annoyed. I just get annoyed. There's no point. People have gotten oddly, like, annoyed about me playing Elden Ring in the way that I play it, so it just makes me a little sad seeing it. I read them all the time and I stop after a bit because it's like Russian roulette. Yeah, true. Anyway, Lucas Kane or Tyler, who do we start as? I got 6 for Tyler and 6 for Lucas. Ooh, a few more on Lucas. We'll go with Lucas. We're going back to Agatha.
The noose is tightening. The police are closing in on me. They'll be back, and next time, they'll take me in.
Agatha was my last chance. She's the only one who seems to understand what's happening to me.
That's totally sounded like Keanu Reeves.
She'll give me some answers.
Agatha? Agatha! It's Lucas!
Are you in the kitchen?
Yoink!
I think she's dead, Zoe! She burned to death because she couldn't find the candles that were lit.
Someone just went out the window.
How do you know?
I need to get your name before I can record your message. Sir, the police cruiser will be there in just a
minute. I'm being framed.
Can you hear me, sir?
I'm being framed.
Agatha.
Okay, we're just gonna leave.
Yoink!
Hold on, if I'm being framed, they might have put something here to Okay, don't touch her, don't touch her, don't touch her! Just check. They may have framed me with an object of some sort. Just have a look.
That's the end of my story.
Excuse me?
I suppose I wasn't strong enough mentally to be able to bear what happened to me. I decided to give myself up to the police. I'll finish the rest of my days in prison, and I'll never know what happened in the restaurant. In the eyes of the world.
What? The timer was so... Okay. No, I swear, man, they'll have left an object. It's like a picture of me or something. Something really obvious. Ooh, a collectible. I really go looking. I got plenty of time. Surely they mean for me to look around.
Brass bathtub. An antique. Must be at least a century or two old. Cupboard is locked.
Okay, maybe I'm just meant to run. Why have they given me so much time? Surely it's just out the window and that's the end of this. Whoa, this room is creepy, man. Let's have a quick scan. Is she gone? Where's her body? Oh, there she is. All right, well, let's get going. Wait, what's that?
Ooh, stuffed owl. The clock has stopped.
Okay, yeah, we're gonna go.
New York police. Anybody there? Hey, Kevin, call an ambulance. There's a body on the floor.
Excuse me. It's the Phantom.
What's up? Anybody home?
Tyler? I didn't expect you so soon. Be a good boy and preheat the oven. Oh, and pour us a couple of glasses of champagne from the fridge. I'll be out in a minute.
Champagne. soon as in a game or movie they say something like that when you come home, it makes me think that you're cheating. Should I go check? Maybe I go check. Oh, I can't. Can I look through this little window? No. There's no evidence of anyone else being here, so. Okay.
Hello, Detective Miles.
Hello.
Do you know what day it is today?
Valentine's Day?
Well, we already had Christmas.
Anniversary?
So 4th of July? No, that's summer. No, you got me.
Tyler.
Okay, babe. It's been exactly 2 years since I met the woman of my dreams.
You want to put some music on? I feel like dancing.
Okay. Sure. This is surely very important for the plot. Hey, Beyond Two Souls. Game's not even out yet at this point. Did they add that in the remastered? Get ready. Okay, sure. Doing a little dancing.
Tyler.
Sorry.
Tyler.
Oh, fucking hell, man. You miss one. Okay, thank God. What is the point of this for the plot? Tyler's feeling horny. Okay, thank God.
Now I had all the pieces of the puzzle. I just needed to put them all together to find our murderer. On my desk lay all the information from Nazer and Jones. On Tyler's desk, the clues from the restaurant.
Okay.
The identity of the killer was here somewhere.
What's this strangely lit paper up here?
The composite photo of the killer.
Memorize. Okay. I've got it memorized. Next.
The list of calls made from the telephone at the restaurant on the night of the murder. The killer might have made one of these calls. No, no connection between those two elements. Detective Valenti.
Hi, Carla. It's Garrett. I called to tell you that I sent you the results of the testing we did on the prints on that pen. They should already be in your email.
Perfect. Thanks, Garrett. I'll take a look right away.
The taxi company should have sent you a list of taxi destinations from the same street as the diner the night of the murder. It should be on the fax in your office.
Thanks. Bye, Garrett.
Bye, Carla.
Okay. Can match the fingerprints, I guess. Okay. I've got the exact fingerprints memorized in my head. Then we go to this fingerprint.
No doubt about it, the prints from the restaurant and the pen come from the same person. I've got my first link. I'll need another in order to establish proof that Kane is our man.
Okay. So.
The list of taxi destinations on the night of the murder. If the killer left the scene in a taxi, his address might be here.
Yeah, so let's memorize that. Do I even have Kane's address?
The torn piece of stock list paper that the killer used as a bookmark. The list of calls made from the telephone at the restaurant on the night of the murder. The killer might have made one of these calls.
I could link that. Did he call for a taxi? He did it. I never called for a taxi, though.
No connection between those two elements.
Okay.
Come in.
Oh, hi, Carla. I saw the light was on, so I thought I'd, come in and say hello.
Nice to see you, Martin. It's calmer here at night. It helps me think a little clearer.
Carla, this has been bothering me for a while. I need to talk to you. You see, I saw the killer from the restaurant. He saved a kid who was drowning in Central Park. The kid would have died without him. I was there when it happened. And it's stupid, but I just couldn't bring myself to arrest him after that. I just figured he'd earned a break. I'm really
after
sorry.
After murdering a man 12 hours earlier?
Don't feel too bad about it, Martin.
What?
I might have done the same thing in your place.
I'll be around for at least another hour.
Figured he needed a break.
Come and see
me. He must have been so stressed after the murder.
Catch you later, Martin.
Catch you later, Martin. Thanks for the quick heads up. Back to work. Not gonna ask about any more details around it. Not gonna show you a picture of the guy I suspect is the killer at the moment.
The Shakespeare book found in Lucas Kane's desk at the bank.
I don't see that helping. Maybe the bookmark. Hold on, you know what? I think every time I guess, it progresses the night. So let me just have a look around. Do I have his address anywhere?
Lucas Kane's fingerprints.
And address? No? Okay. Okay. I don't think I have any more connections to make. Other than this idea, but I don't think this is gonna work. I've got fingerprints, I've already done that. I've got the phone calls made, but I don't think he made a phone call. What's this? Oh, another book. Okay.
The Shakespeare book found at the suspect's table in the diner.
Oh, like part... Are we gonna find they're part of the same...
The two books are from the same collection and have the same dedication. They obviously belong to the same person. This time, there's no reasonable doubt. Lucas Kane is the restaurant killer. I've got to tell Tyler right away.
Oh, Tyler's a little busy. No, Tyler's a little busy. Oh, God.
Don't answer it, lover.
Is he dead? What?
Sorry.
Sorry, babe. I need to answer. It might be important.
Tyler, no!
Hello?
We got him, Tyler.
I'm on my way.
Tyler, I'm warning you. If you leave me now, I will never forgive you.
I won't be long, babe. Just sip some champagne and I'll be right back before you know it. I'm sorry, Sam, but this is
really important. Just gonna arrest a quick killer.
What about me? I'm not important? Tyler!
Tyler, man, at least have a quickie. Going on? Am I about to kill again?
Sorry, we're close. Come back tomorrow.
Oh, I won't be long. Master Natilan, Nekibini Nataquen, Castanekli, Quadiklana, I Quentana.
Watch out! Lady! Lady, watch out! The little girl.
I finally put all of the pieces together. All that's left is to arrest the killer. Captain Jones has given us everything we asked for. There's no chance of him escaping.
Okay, this is it. Everybody in position.
Copy that.
I mean, you stole his to be fair, company property, maybe? It wasn't from his home, right? Well, I don't know. Would it hold up? Hold on, collectibles? No? Collectibles? No? Let's get going. The arrows are all wrong. There we go.
I'll go in first. You cover me.
Okay. What the hell is this?
Cover me. I'm gonna check the doors.
Police! Hands up! Police! Hands up!
We missed him. Well, he's running now.
What the fuck happened in here?
He's running across the street. What should I do, Carla?
Stop him. We're coming.
Copy that.
Come on, Lucas.
It happened again. Somebody died in the lab-o-matic. I saw it like I was there. Agatha's dead, so who's gonna tell me what's going on?
Put your hands in the air.
How's he gonna get out of this one? Here we go, baby.
Damn, the police. They already found me. I'll spend the rest of my days
unless...
rotting in prison, and I'll never find out what really happened. No, it's not gonna happen like that.
Boom, 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 boom. Whoa! Yeah! Wah, wah! He uses the force, then takes care of this cop on his left. Quick punch. Oh my god, Lucas is insane. Not today. The force, use the force. Oh shit! Here we go! He charges them and dodges the bullets. Oh my god! Yes? What's next, dude?
New York police!
Throw the cop car on the helicopter. Oh, no, we gotta run. Okay, sure. We're not that strong. Oh, but we're faster than the cars. Here we go. Nice dodging. Nice dodging. Nice dodging. Beautiful. Beautiful dodging. And then, okay, yeah. Oh. Watch out for that truck slide. Oh my God. How are you gonna, oh shit. How are you gonna get out of this one, man? Oh, watch out. Ah, fuck, I lost a life. Okay. Nice, dodge. 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 Nice. Yeah, use a van. Nice. And then here comes the truck. You gotta slide. You're completely... I fuck it up again. We're about to find out if it's... Okay, what happens now that I've lost out of lives? Lost
life. And that's how my story ends. I felt a strange power within me, but I wasn't capable of using it at that moment.
Oh my God.
Trying to escape from the police. I'll never find out what really happened that cold January night.
Whoo! Good to know. It took a little long for that to show up.
Put your hands in the air.
Okay, we gotta do it all again. I don't mind, man. This looks great.
The police. They already found me. I'll spend the rest of my days rotting in prison, and I'll never find out what really happened.
The coolest character in video game history. Right here. Boom, boom, boom! Sorry. Sorry. Okay, we have to do it all with one life. I really have to focus up. Yeah. Dude, they had some fun with this scene.
Stop or I'll shoot.
Not today. This is the coolest part. Really realistic as well. I love. Boom! One dodge. Two dodge. Can I just also add? Lucas isn't possessed during this? Shit. It's for the best. I think I won two lives. Can I just add? Lucas isn't possessed for this?
I felt a strange power.
He's himself.
I wasn't capable of using it.
Like, there's no magic at play here or anything. This is just Lucas. Dodging bullets and doing backflips.
Damn.
Okay, I gotta focus. Here we go.
They already found me. I'll spend the rest of my days rotting in prison, and I'll never find out what really happened. No, it's not gonna happen like that.
So cool. Nice. Amazing. Lands it. Uses the force real quick on that guy. Not sure what. There's no explanation. On the other ones, at least he's like doing stuff that's physically like, you know, he can go like this, even though he probably can't time it with bullets. I say probably.
Don't move, asshole.
But what's he doing with that first guy? Is he using the wind? Like, what's he, how is he pushing him? Nice.
New York police. Don't move.
You gotta go, buddy. One dodge. Two dodge. Another one. Left again. Right.
Thank you.
Why do I always fail that? Okay, let's watch it again, man.
Power within me, but I wasn't capable of using it at the right moment.
So he's feeling a we are learning something. He's feeling a strange power within him.
Put your hands in the air.
There is.
Damn, the police.
There's some lore going on here.
They already found me. I'll spend the rest of my days rotting in prison, and I'll never find out what really happened. No, it's not gonna happen like that.
The helicopter can just land with him. Okay. Watch out for the train. The train. Backflip onto the train.
That guy just did? Shit, that's crazy.
We need to catch him.
What?
Next time he won't get away.
Did you see what that guy just did? Shit, man, that was crazy. That was crazy. Right, chat. Can anyone tell me roughly, how long is left? Are we talking like an hour? Or are we talking more like 2.5? I gotta plan my playthrough. Long, Lamau. 3 hours. Whoa! More like 5. Whoa! What? Are we about to stick with this craziness? This is like the halfway point. Oh, nice. Let's play a little longer then.
5 men in the hospital. 4 wrecked squad cars, a helicopter that just missed blowing up in our faces. Meanwhile, the killer takes a nice quiet ride on the subway. I hope there's a good explanation for all this.
Carla.
Nothing went according to plan, Captain. The operation was set up by the book and everybody did their jobs, but Kane displayed some abnormal abilities.
Just what are you trying to tell me here? That this guy is Superman? That's your excuse? And you seriously expect me to buy that crap?
Tyler, take over.
Captain, we're not amateurs. If this guy was a tourist, we would have cuffed him and stuffed him in no time. We underestimated him. He's a lot more dangerous than we thought.
I don't give a crap about your two-bit excuses. When the press finds out that Kane slipped through our fingers, they're gonna make me a laughingstock. and the mayor's gonna come looking for my head. Now, what is the plan, people? Are you on his trail?
Carla.
Kane's photo will be in every squad car, train station, and airport. We're going over every inch of his apartment and interrogating his associates. He can't stay hidden forever.
I want every available man on Kane's ass right now. I want him locked up tight in 48 hours or less. You understand me? I want this nut job behind bars before he decides to cut somebody else. Now get out of here!
Why does he sound like he's about to ask for
Carla,
photos of Spider-Man?
Carla, I've been looking for you. We found some of Kane's prints in an apartment where we found the dead body of an old lady. And that's not all. There was a double murder last night in a lavomatic.
She
One
smiles at
him. One of the two victims was killed by knife blows to the heart. Garrett's already there. He's waiting for you.
Mario, man. Alright, let's go with Carla on this one, and then Lucas.
-5 degrees Fahrenheit. Every day it got a little colder. The whole city seemed to be numbed by the snow and ice.
Wow, minus 20 in Celsius. Oh, my recording PC has just blue screened. So give me a second. Just going to let it restart. Minus 20 in Celsius. Crazy, dude. Crazy. Did that not say in Celsius as well? Oh, did it? I missed that if so.
Yoink!
God, minus 20, you know, it's something else, man. When I went for my aunt's 50th birthday up north, I remember that evening, it was an outdoor party with barrels, with open fires in barrels. And it was minus 30. Yeah, it's something else, that kind of cold, man. It's something else. Sorry, I'm just fixing the computer. Family survived with minus 25 Celsius with low covering in the woods. What? Were they lost in the woods? Or what are you saying? They survived minus 25 in the woods with low covering. Boom. Boom, 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 boom. What were they doing stuck in the woods? It was harm time to be in hiding. What? I am not following. It was harm time to be in hiding. I don't really understand what you're saying here, man. Are you saying it's during like a war or something? Oh, hard times. Okay. Damn, dude. Minus 25. You know, if you ever find yourself out in the woods at that cold of a temperature, you gotta huddle up with your buddy. Hug each other. Yeah, I always hate in movies where they're like out in the wilderness and they're cold and they're like, let's go to sleep. And it's like two best friends. And then they sleep separately. They don't cuddle. Like, why? Why wouldn't you share your body heat? Yep, World War II. Damn, dude. That's crazy. I wonder how did they survive that? Sasha, thanks for the $3. You play the game how you want with weapons you enjoy. I use armor in the game I find aesthetically pleasing, even if there are better ones. And still use my starting sword mid-playthrough. Just know that most here get that and get that you have your style. Hey, thanks, Sasha. Cheers. I mean, I'm done with the game now, but I appreciate that, man. It's Blue Jay and Adam Dragons. Welcome, guys. Thanks for subscribing. Jake Ed Dillinger, Envy is High, and Ultra Kill. Thanks for the resubs as well. Brain can't comprehend Fahrenheit to Celsius. Fahrenheit to Celsius is a tough one to convert. I don't think there's any rule to it, right? They're just too different to be able to, you know, it's not, there's no like, just divide the Fahrenheit by two and then add on the first digit to it. You know, like there's nothing like that. There's no rule. You just have to know it. Oh, cool, Swag Boy. Maybe I'll check it out then. There is a formula. Oh, there is? Fahrenheit to Celsius, you subtract 32 and divide 2. Subtract 32, divide 2. Okay, so if it's 80 Fahrenheit, that would make it 24 Celsius. 80 Fahrenheit to Celsius. Oh, 26. Pretty close. Not 2, it's 1.8. Oh. Let's see if that's true. So, if we have 80 Fahrenheit minus 32... divided by 1.8. Okay, well, that's not something I'm going to be able to do in my head. Unfortunately. So I guess you can just subtract a couple. So let's say it's 108 degrees Fahrenheit. That would make it 76 divided by 1.8. So let's put it at 41 degrees. Is that what it is? 108. 42. Okay, yeah. So just divide it by 2 and then throw on a couple, you know? Well.
But nobody was worried about it yet.
Honestly, who came up with the Imperial systems? Oh, listen, man, I've stirred some feathers. Is that the same? Ruffled. I ruffled some feathers the other day. I talked about the, I ranted
inside,
about the Imperial
Tyler.
System for
I'm
a good
talk to
30 minutes.
And see if he found anything.
It was a whole thing.
Who would me? I can't even think out here in this damn cold.
Ah, I was waiting for you, Carla.
So, what happened here?
The guy who runs the Lavamatic found the bodies around 5 o'clock this morning when he came to open up. When he tried to get in, it seemed like the door was blocked from the inside. He saw the two bodies through a window and called the cops.
So he killed him and then killed himself? Clues.
Were there any prints?
Just those of the victims. No prints from Kane, if that's what you're wondering.
Were there any witnesses?
No eyewitnesses. We checked around the neighborhood, but didn't turn up anything. This guy got lucky. He commits a double murder in front of a window, and nobody sees a thing.
Thanks, Garrett. I want to check on a thing or two before I leave. Three or four stabs in the area of the heart. Exactly like the victim in the restaurant. I wouldn't be surprised if the autopsy finds that the arteries are severed.
Why the murders? Do we know that yet? Some sort of like rituals where someone takes over, takes you over basically, and does these things.
Did you notice this blood over here?
The laundromat owner, right there.
Yeah, I saw that. What do you think it means?
Did it, and then most likely killed himself.
The murderer was bleeding before he stabbed his victim, just like in the toilets of the restaurant.
We saw him get taken over by someone.
A knife stuck in his eye. Death would have been instantaneous. Bizarre.
I meant, why these specific people? Oh, no reason. We don't know these guys. They're just random.
His wrists are all cut up. Looks like some kind of symbol carved on them. A snake. A snake with two heads.
Yeah, I guess Lucas was meant to die when he did it to him. Maybe he didn't cut deep enough. Like, maybe this is what was meant to happen. Although I will say, I mean, he shoved it in his eye. Maybe Lucas took over too soon? And that's why he didn't shove the knife up his eye?
Let's go. I've seen enough. What are we supposed to think about this murder?
Oh, fuck! Could I have been him?
Killing the woman? It seems absurd, but the only explanation...
He doesn't get to check around.
I don't think Kane had anything to do with what happened at the laundrette. But, all the same, there's got to be a link between the two murders.
True, Lucas does have actual superpowers now, so...
Lucas.
Agatha, is that you? I thought you were...
Dead. In a way. But I promised to tell you what I know. And I always keep my word. Listen carefully, Lucas. We have very little time. You are not insane. Neither are you a murderer. You are simply at the wrong place, at the wrong time.
Why did they pick me? Why did they want to kill that guy?
Pure chance. They just needed one man to kill another in order to open the mouth of the serpents. You're not the first to be chosen to perform the sacrifice. And certainly not the last.
Why do I have these visions? They are real, aren't they?
In a way, yes. They are using the visions to try and eliminate you. You've seen too much, so you've become an inconvenience. They're coming! Save yourself, Lucas! They want your life! Kuetnitlan, in the ancient Mayan civilization.
What?
You'll find some of the answers you seek there.
Agatha? Agatha! Ooh.
Okay. What the fuck? Oh, get ready. We gotta dodge some angels. Nice, that's one. Watch out for the second one. Close one. Failed, shit. Oh.
And that's how my story ends.
Officially, they called it a suicide. I'd never find out the truth about what...
Let's try again. Fucking Tom Cruise sprint out of there. Oh, they're trying to chop you. Nice. Don't lose now, dear. You're so close. But I didn't! I didn't fail any of them! No! Stop! Oh my god!
Lucas,
thank
wake
God.
Up!
What are you doing here? What happened?
The police found me. I managed to get away. I walked all night. I didn't have anywhere else to go, so I came here.
My God. This time you really have to go to the police, Lucas. There is no other solution.
I'm not turning myself in until I understand what happened.
Powers.
Something strange is happening to me, Marcus. Since the murder, I find I can do abnormal things. I see visions of certain events before they happen. Sometimes I can even hear what people are thinking. And my body has become much stronger and faster.
Nobody has powers like that. You're not turning into a Superman, Lucas.
I saw Agatha again. Here, just a while ago. She's dead, but she had some things to tell me. I think she wants to help me.
Agatha is dead? Are you telling me that you...
No, I didn't kill Agatha, Marcus. She was dead by the time I got there.
But you're saying that you talked to a dead person? None of this makes any sense. So what are you going to do? You can't stay here. The police will certainly come to question me, and probably place me under surveillance.
I have to find some place to hide. I'm a fugitive. My description will go out everywhere. At least now I know that there is an explanation. I need to find the people who are behind all of this.
Be careful, Lucas. They'll kill you if they get the chance.
Yoink. Nothing could be worse than what I see in my visions.
Lucas has gone insane. I'm protecting a murderer. But I can't betray my brother. Dear God, help me. Tell me what I should do.
I really like this game, man. I really like this game. It's funny. In all that, thanks for the 2 months. Websters, good to see you. Thanks for the 26. Glad to brighten your day. And Aaron Customs for the 10 months. Being done with Elden Ring, I assume you have no plans to try the co-op mod for it. Nah, I'm good. Tiffany's place? Lucas is going to Tiffany.
I had nowhere to go. I was exhausted. I felt like I was gonna die, either from the cold or from hunger. I hoped that I could rest for a couple of hours at Tiffany's place, get my energy back, and figure out what to do next. I'd only been to her new apartment once before. I only had a vague memory of exactly where it was, but I was sure that this was the street.
No!
What?
The police. They're watching Tiffany's apartment, of course. They assumed that I'd show up here looking for a place to hide. I have to find another way in.
Just climb the walls like Spider-Man.
Another homeless person. I get the feeling they're everywhere, and they're watching me.
Then...
I must be getting paranoid.
Dude, I'm getting close to suicide. Telling you, man, I'm gonna scale the walls. All right, we got another. Yeah, no problem. Oh my God. Okay. But can I even...
The police.
Okay.
There must be some way to get around.
Thrilling gameplay, can I just say. This is next level. What a man will do for a shag right here. there no... Oh, here we go. Okay. Okay, yeah. No, we're good. Out of time? Well, I did all of that to just get to the other side of them. Surely there was a smoother way to get here. Do I look different? I swear they changed my look. That's not how I look, is it?
That window leads to Tiffany's apartment. If only I could find a way to open it. I think it budged a little. It's open a few inches. I almost had it.
I'm getting cramp.
I wasn't too proud about breaking into Tiffany's apartment like a common criminal, but I had no choice. I hadn't eaten in almost a day. I was starting to feel weak and tired.
What? What are you doing, buddy? Okay? Tiffany? Tiffany? It's me, Lucas. Tiffany. Jam? Peanut butter? Peanuts?
Yoink.
Peanuts. I'm in the kitchen. Oh.
Nothing to eat here. Nothing to eat here.
Tiffany, you in here? Excellent. Hey. Definitely. Oh, let's turn the TV on.
Extremely cold temperatures remain the top story today, with the thermometer dropping to a new record low of minus 15 degrees. Heavy snowfall caused the temporary closing of the Brooklyn Bridge. And sadly, the cold proved fatal for several homeless persons in Harlem and in the Bronx. Europe has not been spared either. Record lows have been registered in numerous countries.
Mysterious restaurant murderer has been identified. His name is Lucas Kane, a man with no prior problems with the law. He was able to escape last night just as local police officers arrived at his home to arrest him. Tragically, his killing spree continues as he took the lives of an old woman and two others in a laundromat. His motive is still unknown, but experts say he's most unlikely mentally ill. The police have distributed Kane's photo to the media and expect an arrest within...
And for an expert's point of view on the subject, we have with us today one of the most renowned specialists on Mayan civilization.
Professor perfect. Dimitri this is exactly what I need to hear about.
Mesoamerican University here in New York. Thanks for being with us today, Professor. You've written a fascinating book on Mayan rituals. And I wanted to ask you if...
A specialist in Mayan civilization? He'd known what Kexnaclan means.
Why wouldn't you listen?
Professor Curie.
Okay, we're gonna go find him instead. Okay, yeah. Wait, what? What's that? Okay, getting a little creepy now.
One new message today at 10:41.
Hello, Miss Harper. I'm Detective Carla Valenti from the New York City Police.
What a lovely.
I'd like to ask you a few questions. I'll try calling you back a little later today.
Oh, shit.
My picture's in all the newspapers. I can be identified by just about anyone in the street now. I'm going to have to be very careful. I guess I'm out of danger for now. I'll wait for Tiffany to get back before I leave.
Okay. Is there anything left to do? Okay. He sat on the couch. Welcome home, honey.
You scared me. What are you doing here?
The police are looking for me. I needed a place to hide for a few hours.
Doesn't say anything.
What happened to you? The papers are saying that you killed several people. Is it true?
The whole thing is very complicated. All I can tell you is that I am not a murderer.
Yoink.
I know you're not capable of doing what they said you did, Lucas. You have to explain. You have to tell them you're innocent.
I've got to find out exactly what's happened to me, Tiffany. That's the only way I can prove my innocence.
Oh, shit. It's the cops. No. Tiff.
Lucas, it's the police. What are we
gonna do? Hide in the shower.
Look,
in the shower.
I'm sure they just want to ask you a few questions. Just stay calm, Tiffany, and answer their questions. I'll hide in the apartment. Everything will be fine. You'll see.
Okay. I'm gonna go
Miss
hide.
Miss Harper, are you home?
In the shower.
Yes. Just a second. I'm coming.
Good luck, Tiff.
Lucas,
good spot.
I can't keep them waiting anymore. I've got to open the door.
It's gonna be fine.
Miss Harper?
Yes?
I'm Detective Tyler Miles, NYPD. I'm working on the Lucas Kane case. I think that you two were romantically involved, isn't that right?
We're involved, yes. But we separated. We broke up about a month ago.
Have you heard from Mr. Kane recently? Has he tried to contact you?
I went by his apartment day before yesterday to pick up the last of my things. We hardly spoke. I haven't heard from him since.
Do you mind if I look around your apartment?
Well, it's just that...
Hey, I'll only be a minute.
Go ahead.
Here we go, baby. Here we go. Get ready. Okay, I gotta hold my breath. Don't slip. Don't make a sound, buddy. You've got the best hiding spot. They'll never find you here. No one ever checks the shower.
Doing a little redecorating?
Yes, the apartment wasn't in very good shape, so I've been painting it. It's taking a long time with my job. I don't have much time to...
And what do you do?
I'm a nurse. I work at St. John's Hospital.
A little cold to have the window open, isn't it, miss? Surely he'd ask that. Knew it. Oh yeah, they always check the bed. But do they check the showers?
Don't move or I shoot!
This is how my story ends. I'll never know what really happened to me in that East End restaurant on that cold January night.
What?
Because as far as everyone is concerned, I'm getting just what I deserve.
I don't understand. What? Why did it just cut? What did I do wrong?
Miss Harper? Miss Harper, are you home?
I'll hide in the closet.
Yes, just a second. I'm coming.
Yoink. This is a great spot.
I can't keep them waiting anymore.
Nah, they'll never find me in here, honey. We're good. Listen, babe. I've got the best spot in the place. They never check the closet. Why would I be in here? You'd keep the clothes in here.
I'm Detective Todd of Miles, NYPD. I'm working on the Lucas Kane case.
Oh my god,
can I
not skip?
I think that you two were romantically involved, isn't that right?
We're involved, yes. But we separated. We broke up about a month ago.
Have you heard from Mr. Kane recently? Has he tried to contact you?
I went by his apartment day before yesterday to pick up the last of my things. We hardly spoke. I haven't heard from him since.
Do you mind if I look around your apartment?
Well, it's just that...
Hey, I'll only be a minute.
Go ahead.
Okay, here we go, here we go, here we go. See him. Fuck. I gotta focus.
Doing a little redecorating?
Yes, the apartment wasn't in very good shape, so I've been painting it. It's taking a long time with my job. I don't have much time to...
And what do you do?
I'm a nurse. I work at St. John's Hospital.
I went up! Okay.
Thank you for your cooperation, miss. If Kane does try to recontact you, please call me right away. Here's my card. Be careful, miss. Kane's a very dangerous man.
The fuck am I doing in an asylum?
Hello. My name's Barney.
Detective Carla Valenti.
You've come to see Janos, isn't that right?
Who's Janos?
Down the second corridor on the right. we finished. Oh, another power outage. It's the sixth time today. Not surprising, though, with this cold weather. Good thing the hospital's got its own backup generator.
Anyone remember this?
Remember, Janice's cell is down the second corridor on the right. One of my colleagues is waiting to open the cell for you. I'll be watching you. Don't worry, you'll be fine.
Thank you, Barney. I wasn't sure exactly what I expected to find out by coming here. Kane was the killer, there was no doubt about that. And yet, I needed to know just what happened in the strange case of the Kirsten killings.
Got it, okay. I guess this is where one of the killers are. I feel like I've missed a scene about it.
Hello, detectives. I'll wait for you here.
Perfect, thanks.
It's Hannibal Lecter. There he is. The one and only. Watch him do his thing as well. Is that what he does?
Hello, I'm Detective Carla Valenti of the New York Police Department. I'd like to ask you a few questions, if it's all right with you, of course.
Picture.
I see you like to draw. That's quite nice. What is it exactly?
Why have you gone to the trouble of coming to see me, Detective Valenti? I'm mad, you know. What I have to say is meaningless. Isn't that right?
Maybe it'll make sense to me. Please, Anton, tell me everything that you know.
A man and a woman in a laundromat. She's a little overweight, Hispanic looking. Him, he has a knife planted in his eye.
How do you know that?
I was there. I can see through his eyes. Every one of the murders. I'm there.
And you, Anton, why did you kill that man?
I didn't kill anyone. I was just his instrument. I hear his voice in my head, and I see the blood. Always, always. It has to stop.
Who is the murderer?
Nobody knows. Nobody sees him. He leaves no trace in people's memories. But I know. I know he exists. He's among us, invisible. He's everywhere.
There have been other identical murders, haven't there?
The killings won't stop until they've found the little girl.
Why? Why are they killing?
Oh, the world's not...
How about asking about the little girl?
The Orange Clan are secretly running everything. They're watching us, listening to us all of the time. They record what you say. They know what you're doing each second of the day. They're everywhere.
How is this connected to the murders?
They want ultimate power. They want the answer to the question of life. They want to be eternal.
I have to go now, Anton.
What?
Thank you for your help.
You only hear about the little girl once, and that's now. And you don't ask anything? They won't stop unless they find the little girl.
The end of humanity.
Okay, whatever.
The end of humanity.
Sort of spiral drawn hundreds of times on the wall of the cell.
Ah, do you want to know what my drawings mean? The response to all questions. The beginning of the end. The alpha and the
the Omega.
All will end there.
Everything go all right? I'll walk you to the...
Oh, shit.
Damn it. This time it looks serious. It looks to me like our backup electrical generator hasn't...
What's that on your left, buddy?
It'll come on. Sometimes it takes a minute. We'll wait here in the meantime.
Oh, no.
What was that noise?
Oh, shit. The cell doors. All of the cell doors have been opened. The electrical outage must have screwed up the autolock system.
What? You mean the patients are free to leave their cells and nothing...
Wait. Don't move. Don't make any noise. We don't want them to locate us here. Just keep cool, and we'll wait for the lights to come on. Relax. Stay close to me.
The aide. They got him.
What?
I have to move from you, or they'll find me too. If I don't breathe more calmly, I'm gonna faint. And then... No!
That's how everything came to an end. I couldn't control my fear, and it ended up killing me.
I tried to click LB. Is it not LB and RB in the breathing thing? Oh, maybe it's the sticks. No, it's LTRT. Okay, I think I remember. It's not LT. Okay, LB? No, it's LB. I clicked LB.
I couldn't control
it. I clicked LB and I was fine. Am I meant to LB, RB, LB, RB? Is that it? Breathe, okay. LB, RB, RB? Okay, LB. RB. LB, RB, LB, RB, LB, RB, LB, RB. There we go, okay. LB, RB?
Oh no, I hear one coming. He's getting so close. Breathe, Carla. Don't move. Hold your breath. He's going away. I can keep moving.
I don't know where to go. Am I meant to go here?
He's right there.
Everything came to an end. I couldn't control.
Can I go in here?
No!
It's a different
everything came to an end.
Shot.
I couldn't control my fear. And it ended up
God, you made it out. I don't know what the hell could have happened. The auto lock system opened all of the cell doors. Are you hurt? Are you sure you're all right?
Great, Barney. I feel great. I love playing hide and seek in the dark with a pack of psychopathic killers.
Well, what about the other dude? Okay, yep. Right, I'm going to end today's session there. That's a really nice place to end it, right before we dwell deep into wherever it's going to go from here. So, what do we think? What's everybody's thoughts? I'm really enjoying it, man. It's so entertaining.